the WB Television Network. Shows that speak to our young adult audience from an empowered point of view. Our lineup begins with the WB's New Tuesday. The winning powerhouse team of Gilmore Girls and Smallville remain solid on the WB's New Tuesday. Anchoring the night is the critically acclaimed Gilmore Girls, a series about a mother, her daughter, and their unique relationship.
What kind of chaperone are you?
V, I'm not trying to be a chaperone. I'm trying to be a girlfriend.
Well, switch gears, because I'm freaking out here.
Lauren Graham and Alexis Bledel star in Gilmore Girls. Then Smallville, last season's breakout hit.
Something besides the meteors came down that day.
Like what?
A ship.
The mysteries of his life begin to unfold. Smallville. The WB Wednesday begins with the series that defined the WB. Now in their sophomore year of college, life's decisions become even more difficult.
I started this year thinking that I had to say goodbye to you, but I was wrong.
In its sixth season, Dawson's Creek. Then, from the producers of Smallville, the Batman legacy takes an unexpected turn. Out of the union of Batman and Catwoman came a daughter.
Who the hell are you?
I'm the Huntress, and you're the prey.
The Huntress joins forces with two others to become the reluctant guardians of New Gotham.
It might be good for me to go kick some ass.
Birds of Prey. The WB Thursday brings a major shift in scheduling with a new night of comedy. To kick off the night is a modern retelling of a television classic. A butler and a bachelor's perfect lives are turned upside down.
And for you, Mrs. Beasley, per your request, low sodium soy sauce so you don't bloat.
No, don't thank me. It's my job.
Tim Curry.
His name's French, but he's really English.
The WB's Family Affair.
Oh, dear God, we're keeping them.
The laughs continue with the ultimate wish fulfillment comedy, Do-Over. A freak accident sends Joel Larson 20 years into the past.
What year is it?
2002.
It's 1981, but close.
A 34-year-old man trapped in a 14-year-old body. Joel has been given the opportunity to go back in time and change his past.
Holly Kent. I always wanted to talk to her, but I could never get up the guts. Well, today that changes. Or not.
Do-Over. Following is the freshman comedy hit, The Jamie Kennedy Experiment. Jamie can be anyone, anytime, any place. He takes the hidden camera places it's never been before.
That's him, dude.
It's not.
They party hard.
Dude.
The Jamie Kennedy Experiment. Then, the guys who brought you two slices of American pie are dishing out even more comedy. In a city of 8 million women live four guys without a clue.
You want to get lucky?
What did you have in mind?
I don't know. I didn't think I'd get this far.
Off center. The WB Friday night. It's all comedy all night. Nickelodeon's three-time Kids' Choice Award winner Amanda Bynes and 90210 sensation Jenny Garth team up in a tale of two sisters sharing an apartment in New York City.
I feng shuied the apartment. Is that my bed? In the kitchen? It was the only place where I could face north. For quiet slumber.
What I Like About You. In her third season on the WB, Melissa Joan Hart is Sabrina. Next, it's People's Choice Award winner Reba McEntire in her breakout hit comedy. This season, the not-so-traditional American family returns with two diaper-clad additions.
I think my water broke.
Oh, no! You're sitting on my purse!
Reba. Then, it's an unconventional Mexican-American family comedy.
Of all the parts of my Mexican heritage that I'm most proud of, taking the extended family to the mall in one car to buy one item is probably my favorite.
This family just moved up to a better class.
We were thinking of getting some work done in our yard, and I saw those Mexicans building a wall for you. Maybe I could get their number from you?
I know it by heart, because I'm married to one of them. The cute one.
Critics are already calling it groundbreaking. Greetings from Tucson. The WB Sunday primetime begins 2 hours earlier. It's an innovative new strategy of multi-play presentations of the WB's signature quality dramas. Then, Sunday night takes a supernatural turn. Alyssa Milano, Holly Marie Combs, and Rose McGowan work their magic into a fifth season.
Look at us. We are so bewitched.
Charmed. Next, Sunday night is charmed by an angel. Critics rave, it's enormously entertaining. This show rocks in its fourth season, Angel. The WB Monday is still one of our most compelling nights. In its seventh season, our highest rated show, Seventh Heaven. Now that Matt is married and has moved out, the Camdens are going through a few changes.
I am 18 and I don't want to talk about it.
You and Mom may not want to see it, but I'm a man.
I'll just go.
Seventh Heaven. This fall, the search for the perfect companion for Seventh Heaven has led to the powerful new family drama, Everwood.
We're moving.
Where?
Everwood, Colorado.
Dr. Andrew Brown's life changed the day his wife died. Now he's left to raise two children that he barely knows.
Everyone who wants to move and get their own horse, raise your hand.
He gave so much of himself to the world.
You were never around. We all just tolerated you. Mom would never have done this to us.
There was nothing left to give to those who mattered most.
I need to prove to my wife that I can be the kind of father that she wanted me to be when she was alive.
Treat Williams, and introducing Gregory Smith, Everwood. Quality dramas and comedies that appeal to a younger, diverse audience. Stories of humanity and wish fulfillment told with relatable characters. This is the WB.